And we start in Iverstead.
Bears are driving me crazy.
Boy, now that is. Doggone it. I don't get a chance to talk to Kimmick. Maybe because it's too late.
Pardon me, my lord.
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted.
Thank you.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you right this way. Let me know if there's anything else you need.
I love that music. Yeah.
Those bears are making Miss Timba so angry. I hope you can do something about them.
Okay.
I wish my deliveries more often, but the roads get dangerous.
Hey, there you are.
Passing through on your way to High Hrothgar? About to make a delivery up there myself.
What types of deliveries do you make?
Mostly food supplies like dried fish and salted meats. You know, things that keep fresh for a long time. The Graybeards tend not to get out much, if you catch my meaning.
And in return?
Well, it's kind of an understanding between us. I mean, it just wouldn't feel right to charge them for a bit of preserved food. Trouble is, my legs aren't what they used to be, and climbing the 7,000 steps takes its toll.
I could do it for you.
Really? Well, that would be kind of you. Here, take this bag of supplies. At the top of the steps, you'll see the offering chest. Just leave the bag inside, and you're done.
All right.
Be careful up there.
Oh, I will. The 7,000 steps. Has anyone counted them? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I've lost count. It's nice.
keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
I will. What are you doing?
I like to spend time up here. Walk the steps. Meditate on the emblems. Doesn't hurt when I bag some game along the way.
Do you visit the Graybeards?
They're not the sort to take visitors. But I never go that high up the path anyway. Some folk who make the trip leave them food or other essentials. But not to make conversation.
I see.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Yes. The emblems. That sucks. A lot of steps. Okay. Okay. Just a second, let's read the etched emblem. We're on a trip. Okay, whoops. Where did the stuff go? Clearly need to use a different weapon. I just missed something. No. where the woman is sitting, who doesn't want to talk to anybody.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to Hyrothgar.
Who are you?
Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind.
Oh, I can see your name is Karita. What are you doing?
Walking the steps, meditating on the emblems. I make this trip every few years.
All right.
Until next time.
Where is that troll? I can't help but feel we're in a trap. I need better arrows. Emblem 6. The Way of the Voice. Jurgen Windcaller. Look at this. It's a beautiful thing. and the final meditation. I think I missed one, didn't I? Oh well. Okay.
Dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
You call me Dragonborn. What does that mean?
First, let us see if you truly are Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
Taste of my voice. Okay. I'll give you a little taste of my voice.
Master Arngeir, I speak for the Graybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here?
I want to find out what it means to be Dragonborn.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit, just as the Graybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you.
But I'm a cat. I mean, I'm not the only Dragonborn?
You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon humankind. Whether you are the only Dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say.
Who are you? What is this place?
We are the Graybeards, followers of the Way of the Voice. You stand in High Hrothgar, the slopes of Kinnarith's sacred mountain. Here we commune with the voice of the sky and strive to achieve balance between our inner and outer selves.
Well, I'm ready to learn.
You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn.
Yes, listener. I'll remain in this location until ordered otherwise.
Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Ro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply.
Bro.
In order to use it in a shout.
Okay. Okay.
Well, that is how the rest of us learn shunts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Rome.
Oh, I like that.
Let us see how quickly you can master your new thorn. Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear. Well done. Again. You learn quickly. Once more. Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
Wish Master Bori would move a little more quickly.
We will now see how you learn a completely new shot. Master Bori will teach you Wuld, which means whirlwind.
Wuld.
You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thorn. Approach Master Bori and he will gift you his knowledge of Wuld.
Give me some Wuld.
Master Wolfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bori.
X.
Wolf.
Okay.
Now it's your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes. Your quick mastery of a new thumb is astonishing.
Yeah.
I've heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself.
Thank you. What's next?
You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jurgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice. You will return.
Alrighty. Who was Jurgen Windcaller?
He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jurgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born.
Cool. Okay. I think we'll, go grab my homegirl and we'll take off. Whoops. I've totally turned around, dude. I don't know where I am. Oh.
How may I serve you, my listener? Yes, listener.
All right. Let's go get the horn of Jurgen Windcaller. Picked a terrible time. Rumble between necromancers and bandits. Why aren't you guys fighting with each other anymore? Chest here? All right. butter. Sounds like spiders somewhere. Oops. That's what I want to see. You have that very, very sad look in your, or tired look on your face. Annie, have a good night. That sucked.
Yeah.
Listener, it's an honor to stand before you.
Okay. Oops. Remember how the heck I got back up there.
Walk always in shadow, my listener.
I just want to know how to get out. Yes, yes, done all this. Ah! Well, that was fun.
You.
I, we're the only people in Skyrim worth loving. That's what I think.
I know, I know.
What do you need, love? Ask anything.
I need to go to sleep. Whoops.
How may I serve you, my listener?
Honored to see you again, my Thane.
That's not what I meant.
Long life to you, Thane.
Yes, listener. How may I serve you? Yes, listener. I'll return to the Dawnstar Sanctuary without delay. How may I serve you, my listener?